Hi guys, Matt Thomas here at Cedar Rock Studio Guitar Gallery in Indiana, and today we've got the very coveted Greenfield guitar on my lap. Now this is actually the G1, so it's not one of the big, giant, massive ones. To me, it's kind of like an OM-inspired shape. But what makes it that much more comfortable is this beautiful Laskin arm bevel, but we'll get into that. Now it has a beautiful Adirondack top on it that has, oddly, a lot of silking for Adirondack, but as you can see, it's kind of got a little bit of age and UV to it, so it's darkened a little bit here. Obviously, it's been played outside a good bit, but it's definitely, it's been played. It sounds nice and broken in. But look at this gorgeous Brazilian rosewood. I love that center sapwood matchbook here. And he went ahead and did an enlarged ebony backstrip through here. And it's ebony bound all the way around with a really micro double maple purfling scheme that is just itty bitty. It's quite lovely. But as you turn it around the sides, you can see it's got just a little bit of sapwood peeking out on the sides as well. Now it's got that signature spalted maple rosette that Greenfield does. But what I thought was interesting is instead of the pink paw trim, he did a green abalone all the way around of this spalted maple rosette here. Now it's got an ebony bridge that's got 2 1/4 spacing and ebony pins. And as you get into the fretboard here, it's got an ebony fretboard, but it's got this, down the trim, it's got that double maple purfling right in the middle of the ebony that actually goes right through the middle of these green abalone fret dots as well, which is kind of a cool concept. Now it has a multi-piece neck here that looks like it's 7 pieces. So it's mahogany with a thin strip of ebony, maple, rosewood, maple, ebony, mahogany. So it's a very stable and stiff neck. So all the energy goes right to the body, but it also allows it to stay pretty straight in between tunings, so it doesn't move around very much. Now it is 1 3/4 here at the nuts, so it's not, you know, super wide. It's very comfortable. But what I thought's quite interesting is the volute is inverse. So rather than the volute sticking outward, it actually dips in here at the nut, which really allows you, if you try to do a chord here, you don't have to grab a big mass and meat right here. So it allows you to get way, way down here without having any hindrance. So at the head cap here, it's got a dark ebony head cap with that beautiful G for Greenfield. And as you flip it over, it's got a Brazilian rosewood back cap. But what I want to mention is it's got those really micro veneers underneath of both the head plates. So you end up seeing this maple black maple scheme that's on the purfling all the way around as well, which is, I mean, it is very, very thin. That must have taken a lot of work to get those that thin and work with. Now, this thing sounds like it's been broken in and played very much. It's got a beautiful immediate tone, but you really, even though it's Adirondack, you don't have to drive it super hard. You can play it nice and soft. Or if you just want to really dig in, you can. He does a beautiful lattice bracing that really makes every note across this fretboard just sound very even all the way through. Every string kind of has its own voice. So I see why everybody has fallen in love with these guitars. So if you have any further questions about this amazing Michael Greenfield G1 guitar, message Alan at cedarrockstudio.com, and thanks for listening.